Good morning students. So yesterday we have learned about the cell, what is the cell, and some cell organelles like the nucleus we have seen in the last class. So in this class we are going to learn about the cell organelles. So cell organelles. So here we have different cell organelles. So first one we shall see about the mitochondria. So in order to find out the observe the mitochondria under microscope, here we have a lab activity. So here in lab activity, what are the materials required? Means first you have to prepare. You have to take a onion peel, and you have to prepare Janus green bean solution. So how to prepare this Janus green bean solution means, so you have to mix 200 mg of Janus green bean solution in 100 ml of water. So like this you can prepare this Janus green bean solution. So after preparing this, you have to take an onion peel, and you have to take a watch glass, and pour some Janus green bean solution in that watch glass, and you have to put this onion peel, and you have to leave it for half an hour. So after half an hour, you have to remove this onion peel from that solution, and you have to put that onion peel on a slide. So on the slide, you have to keep this onion peel, and you should thoroughly wash it with the water. So after that, you have to observe this slide under the microscope in higher magnification. So when you observe under the microscope, you can find the mitochondria, which are the small oval or cylindrical in a shape. So the structures are nothing but the mitochondria. So here, now let us learn about this mitochondria. So here we have the structure. Thank you. mitochondria. So this is the outer membrane. This is the inner membrane. This are the crystal. This is the matrix. So when we observe under the microscope, we find this mitochondria as a spherical or oval structures. So the mitochondria contains a double membrane or a double layered wall. So here the inner membrane of mitochondria is folded into inside, and that structures are called as the crystae. So in between these crystae, so the fluid that is present in this in between these crystae, it is called as the matrix. So here what is the, so the length so the mitochondria is 2 to 8 micron long and 0.5 micron wide. So and each cell you can find about 100 to 150 mitochondria, and these mitochondria are 150 times smaller than the nucleus. So here this mitochondria is also one of the most important organelle in the cell. So here, and what is the function of the mitochondria? Means the mitochondria helps in cellular respiration. The mitochondria helps in cellular respiration. So here in the mitochondria provides the necessary energy that is required for the cell to do its work. So for this reason the mitochondria are also called as the powerhouse of the cell. The mitochondria are also called as the powerhouse of the cell. So here after seeing this mitochondria, you have to know about what is the main function of this mitochondria. It mainly helps in the cellular respiration because the cell derives its energy from this mitochondria. So here for this reason only this mitochondria is especially called as the powerhouse of the cell. So this is about the mitochondria. Next, observing the chloroplast in a Ryo leaf. So observing the next one are the plastids. So in plastids only we have the chloroplast or one type of plastids. So you have observed the chloroplast in the Ryo leaf. Here also we have a lab activity. So you have to take a Ryo leaf and cut it in a single stroke, and you have to observe it under the microscope. So when you observe under the microscope, you can find small granule like structures in the cytoplasm that are nothing but the chloroplast. So here in the chloroplast, one main substance is present that is called as the chlorophyll. As you have known about this chlorophyll very well in your, from your lower sections onwards, this term you have been heard. So the chlorophyll in plants, what is the function of the chlorophyll, where it is present? So in plants, main prepares food to the plant. So for this reason the leaf is called as the food factory of the plant. So here not only in the leaf but also the structures like tender stems which are green in color, we can find this chlorophyll in all these structures, and the main function is the preparation of food in the presence of sunlight. So what do you call this process of preparing food by the leaf using chlorophyll in the presence of sunlight? So there is one name for this, the process. So the process, it is called as photosynthesis. So the process photosynthesis only the leaf can prepare its food using the sunlight and also the chlorophyll, etc. So next, observing the chloroplast in the algae. So here, where do you can find algae? Means collect some algae from the pond. So here in the pond you can see the green colored structures. So in Telugu you will call as pachi antaramata. So here collect the algae from the pond and separate the thin filaments of algae and observe it under the microscope. So here the chloroplast is a type of plastids in green color. So chloroplasts are the type of plastids which are green in color. So and also the chloroplast helps in the plastids are present only in the plant cells only. So you cannot find it in the animal cells. So plastids are mainly of three types. What are those? Chromoplast, chloroplast and leucoplast. So plastids are three types: chromoplast, chloroplast and leucoplast. So we know that the chloroplast will be green in color, leuco means white in color, and chromoplast that are the colored. So these are the three types of plastids. So chloroplasts are of the different shapes also, disc, oval, etc. So in algae these can be found as a ladders. So in algae these can be found as the ladders, etc. So here are stars, spirals or reticulate. So the diameter of chloroplast in higher plants can vary between 4 to 10 micron. So in higher plants the chloroplast diameter may vary from 4 to 10 microns. So as I have told you already, the main function of the chloroplast is to trap the energy from sunlight and transform it into the chemical energy, thus helping to carry out the photosynthesis. So the main function of the chloroplast is to trap the light energy from sunlight and transform it into the chemical energy. So this is nothing but the photosynthesis. So certain organelles are present in large number in the cell. So for example, the cells involved in the photosynthesis may contain around 50 to 200 chloroplasts. 50 to 200 chloroplasts. So this is about the plastids. So next one you have the ribosomes. So what are ribosomes? So they there are small granule like structures in the cytoplasm of the cell. These are nothing but they are called as the ribosomes. So what are these ribosomes mainly made up of? Means the ribosomes are mainly made up of RNA and protease. Ribosomes are mainly made up of RNA and proteins. So there are two types of ribosomes. So free ribosomes, these are scattered in the cytoplasm. Free ribosomes scattered in the cytoplasm. And another type of ribosomes we can find that they are attached to the endoplasmic reticulum, surface of the rough endoplasmic reticulum. And what is the function of these ribosomes? Means the ribosomes are the main site for protein synthesis. The ribosomes are main site for the photosynthesis. So this is about the ribosomes. So next one, you have the endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum. So we can find it as, we can also call it as the ER. So here endoplasmic reticulum. So when we observe under the cell under the microscope, you can find a network or a framework of structures in the cytoplasm that is nothing but the endoplasmic reticulum. So here throughout this network creates passages within the cytoplasm for the transport of substances from one part of the cell to the another. Here it is the function of the endoplasmic reticulum. So here the endoplasmic reticulum creates the passages for the transport of materials from one part of the cell to the another. So this network of membranes, it is called as endoplasmic reticulum. So here we have the diagram. This is the diagram of the endoplasmic reticulum. It is a network or the framework of the structure. Endoplasmic reticulum, we have already learned that the ribosomes are of two types. So first type is scattered in the cytoplasm as a free ribosomes, and the second type is, so they are attached to the surface of the endoplasmic reticulum, small granule like structures. Thank you. different structures are the ribosomes. So the endoplasmic reticulum on which the ribosomes are attached is called as the rough endoplasmic reticulum, or you can call it as a RER, that is nothing but the rough endoplasmic reticulum. And here on the other side you can see the endoplasmic reticulum in which the ribosomes are not attached. So that endoplasmic reticulum is called smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So here in endoplasmic reticulum also we have two types, rough endoplasmic and also smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So here the endoplasmic reticulum structure is somewhat similar to the structure of the plasma membrane. So rough, we already learned that the rough endoplasmic reticulum is the site for the protein manufacture. Rough endoplasmic reticulum is the site for the protein manufacture, and the smooth endoplasmic reticulum is the site for the manufacture of the fat molecules and the lipids. Fat molecules and the lipids. So here, and these two functions are very important for the cell function. So here the manufactured proteins, fats, lipids are sent to the various places of the cell depending on the need. So the main function of endoplasmic reticulum is that it helps in the transport of substances. So from one part of the cell to the another, and some of these proteins and lipids also helps in building the cell membrane. So this is the structure of the endoplasmic reticulum. So again, what you have here, what you have to observe here means, so here the smooth endoplasmic reticulum also helps in the detoxification of poisons and drugs. So here we have known that the ER or endoplasmic reticulum helps to serve in the passage of transport of materials, especially the proteins, which helps mainly in the function or building of the cell membrane, etc. So like this the endoplasmic reticulum functions. So here now the smooth endoplasmic reticulum helps in the detoxifying of the poisons and drugs from the liver cells. So this is the main function of this endoplasmic reticulum. So next one, you have in the next also you have the other cell organelles. So up to now we have learned about the nucleus. So here you can find in the book. So if you have the textbooks, you can find this. So the diagrams, you have endoplasmic reticulum, chloroplast, and also here you have this mitochondria, etc. So you have to also practice this diagrams. So and also you have, yesterday class I have drawn this nucleus. So the diagram of the nucleus also. So these are the different cell organelles that we have learned up to now. So next, what are the other, up to now what we have learned, the nucleus, mitochondria, chloroplast, ribosomes, endoplasmic reticulum. So up to now we have seen about this. Now let us again recollect the functions of these cell organelles. So nucleus, what is the function of the nucleus? So the nucleus is one of the most important cell organelle in the cell, and it controls all the activities of the cell. So it is called as the cell's control room. So next, mitochondria. What is the function of mitochondria? Means the mitochondria helps in the cellular respiration. So it provides the energy to the cell to do its work. So for this reason only the mitochondria is called as the powerhouse of the cell. So next one, what you have, this chloroplast. These are a type of plastids, and also these are green colored structures. In this chloroplast only chlorophyll is present. This chlorophyll helps in the preparation of food in the leaf through a process called the photosynthesis. So for this reason the leaf is called as the food factory of the plant. So next one, you have this ribosomes. So ribosomes are the small granule like structures which are present in the cytoplasm. So these are of two types, scavenged type, scattered in the cytoplasm as free ribosomes, and another type, they are attached to the surface of the endoplasmic reticulum, that is called as rough endoplasmic reticulum. And the main function of the ribosomes is the protein synthesis. So next one, you have the endoplasmic reticulum. So this endoplasmic reticulum function is a transport of materials from one place to the another place in the cell. So and also the manufacture of proteins, and also the lipids and fat synthesis also takes place in the endoplasmic reticulum. So as we have told, these are two types, rough endoplasmic and smooth endoplasmic. So here rough is for protein synthesis and smooth is for the lipid synthesis. And also these lipids and proteins manufacture also helps in the building of the plasma membrane. So in this, the smooth endoplasmic reticulum also helps in the detoxifying of the toxins and the drugs in the liver cells and what. So here, so as you, if you have the textbooks, once you read the lesson and also the practice the diagrams, what up to now what you have completed here. So these the cell organelles. So next, another cell organelles what you have here means, so next one, you have the Golgi complex. Next you have the lysosomes, and also you have the vacuoles. So these you have again here. So these cell organelles you will see in the next class. So up to now what we have completed is the before cell organelles, you have to be thorough with that cell organelles. Whatever the information I told about the cell organelles, and the you have to also practice the diagrams. So the next, so here main this lesson is about the cell, mainly its structure and also the functions. So these cell organelles are all present inside the cell in the cytoplasm. So here next you have the Golgi complex, lysosomes, and also the vacuoles. These are also the cell organelles which are present in the cytoplasm of the cell. So this we will continue in the next